Hi friends, welcome to channel AgriBiotic. I am Ganesh Thakur. In this video, we will discuss on some important and previously asked questions from reproduction chapter. This is the third part of video NEET Biology Reproduction. You may watch first video and second video by using link given in video description. So, let's see the questions. First question of this video is, the early stage human embryo processes, and the given options are A. Eyebrows, B. Gills, C. Gill slits, and D. External air, that is pinnae. And here the correct answer is C. Gill slits. The early stage human embryo processes gill slits. So for this question, correct option would be C. Gill slits. Come to the next question. When pollen tube enters through micropyle, the process is called A. Porogamy, B. Chalazogamy, C. Apogamy, and D. Mesogamy. And here the correct answer is A. Porogamy. Porogamy is the condition when the pollen tube enters the ovule from the micropylar end. Chalazogamy is the condition of entering of pollen tube from chalaza. Mesogamy is the condition when the pollen tube enters via the integuments, and apogamy is a type of reproduction in which the sporophyte develops from the gametophyte without fusion of gametes. So, for this question, correct option would be A. Porogamy. When pollen tube enters through micropyle, the process is called porogamy. Next question is, in human, the oocyte is maintained in a state of meiotic arrest by secretion of, and the options given are A. Zona pellucida, B. Cumulus oophorus, C. Granulosa cells, and D. Theca. And here the correct answer is C. Granulosa cells. A granulosa cell or follicular cell is a somatic cell of the sex cord that is closely associated with the developing female gamete called an oocyte or egg in the ovary of mammals. The major function of granulosa cells include the production of sex steroids as well as myriad of growth factors thought to interact with the oocyte during its development. So, for this question, correct option would be C. Granulosa cells. Come to the next question. Sheon is the term used in relation to embryology, grafting, agamospermy, emasculation. And here, the correct answer is B. Grafting. Grafting is a horticultural technique where tissues of two plants are joined so as to continue their growth together. The upper part of the combined plant is called the sheon, while the lower part is called the root stock. Hence, for this question, correct answer is B. Grafting. Next question. The function of copper T is to prevent, and the given options are egg maturation, implantation of blastocyst, fertilization, and ovulation. For this question, correct option would be B. Implantation of blastocyst. Copper T is a small device made up of copper which is inserted into the uterus. It prevents implantation of blastocyst. So, for this question, correct option would be B. Come to the next question. In the human female, menstruation can be deferred by the administration of A. LH only, B. Combination of FSH and LH, C. Combination of estrogen and progesterone, and D. FSH only. And here the correct option would be C. Combination of estrogen and progesterone. When the production of progesterone and estrogen hormone stops in blood. This leads to shed of the lining of uterine endometrium. Therefore, by supply of estrogen and progesterone, the menstruation can be deferred. So for this question, correct option would be C. Next question. If for some reason the vasa efferentia in human reproductive system get blocked, the gametes will not be transported from A. epididymis to vas deferens, B. ovary to uterus, C. testes to epididymis, and D. vagina to uterus. And here the correct answer is C. testes to epididymis. Vasa efferentia connects red testes with an epididymis. If the vasa efferentia get blocked, the sperm will not be transported from testes to epididymis. So for this question, correct option would be C. testes to epididymis. Come to the next question. Anemophily is pollinated by, and the given options are water, insects, air, and birds. And here the correct option would be C. air. When pollen is transported by wind, this is called anemophily. So for this question, correct option would be C. air. Next question is, notochord, skeletal, and dermis of the skin are the derivatives of endoderm, mesoderm, ectoderm, and all of the above. And here the correct option is B. mesoderm. Mesoderm, the middle of the three germ layer or masses of cells which appears early in the development of an embryo. In vertebrates, it subsequently gives rise to muscle, connective tissue, cartilage, bone, notochord, blood, bone marrow, lymphoid tissue, and to the epithelia of blood vessels, lymphatic vessels, body cavities, kidneys, uterus, gonad, genital duct, adrenal cortex, and certain other tissues. So for this question, correct option would be mesoderm. Notochord, skeletal, and dermis of the skin are the derivatives of mesoderm. Come to the next question. Cavity of Graafian follicle is called, and the given options are A. ventricoil, B. blastocoil, C. antrum, and D. archentrum. And here the correct option would be C. antrum. Cavity of Graafian follicle is called antrum. The cavity of follicle, that is antrum, is filled with a fluid called the liquor folliculi, which has a high concentration of estrogens. So for this question, correct answer is C. antrum. Cavity of Graafian follicle is called antrum. Come to the next question. In human, the unpaired male reproductive structure is A. prostate, B. seminal vesicle, C. bulbourethral gland, and D. testes. And here the correct answer is A. prostate. The prostate is a single walnut-sized gland located between the bladder and the penis. The urethra runs through the center of the prostate. The prostate secretes fluid that nourishes and protects sperm. So for this question, correct option would be A. prostate. Next question. Which of the following is pollinated by water? And the given options are Viola, Yucca, Zostera, and Oxalis. And here the correct answer is C. Zostera. Pollination with the water is called hydrophily. Plants which occur below the water level are called submerged plants. When pollination occurs in these plants, it is called hypohydrophily. Examples are Zostera, Nazas, etc. So, for this question, correct option would be C, Zostera. Come to the next question. Corpus luteum releases estrogen, progesterone, androgen, and all of the above. And here, the correct option is B, progesterone. The corpus luteum secretes progesterone, which is a steroid hormone responsible for the growth and maintenance of fetus. The corpus luteum is essential for establishing and maintaining pregnancy in females. So, for this question, correct option would be B, progesterone. Corpus luteum releases progesterone. Come to the next question. Gametes are formed in animals from, and the given options are A, muscular tissue, B, nervous tissue, C, epithelial tissue, and D, all of the above. And here, the correct option would be C, epithelial tissue. Gametes are formed from the cells of germinal epithelium, which is a simple epithelial tissue. So, for this question, correct option would be C, epithelial tissue. Gametes are formed in animals from epithelial tissue. And the last question of this video is, structure connecting the fetus of placenta is A, amnion, B, chorion, C, umbilical cord, and D, yolk sac. And here the correct option is C, umbilical cord. The umbilical cord connects the developing embryo or fetus with the placenta. So for this question, correct option would be C, umbilical cord. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video. For any suggestion, comment in the comment box and don't forget to subscribe our channel AgriBiotech. Thank you.